Welcome to the California state-specific exam Q&A review number 3. In our past couple of videos, we did kind of basic legal principles of surveying. Doesn't matter whether you're in California or New York, they'd be the same. But now we start getting into state-specific stuff because California doesn't want a national surveyor. California wants to produce a California surveyor. That means knowing the acts, the rules, the Subdivision Map Act, and all the other statutes that go along with practicing as a surveyor in California. The call of the question says, congrats, you just passed all of your surveyor exams and have been issued a license to practice by the board. Sweet. Your first jobs are hard to come by, so friends and family are all asking you to do a land survey on their property. That's what good friends and family do. While you are still working for the city planning department, your uncle asks you to create a 4-lot subdivision that will eventually become a series of duplexes. At a minimum, what must you do before beginning this job? So what's going on here is you have 2 jobs. You've got a job during the day at the city planning department, and it sounds like you are reviewing subdivisions because why else would this question be set up like that? But at night, you're really trying to get your teeth into actual surveying. So you are offering your services as a sole proprietor in your evenings and weekends. So what's the problem? Well, you are going to produce a land survey subdivision map, and your own county, the people you work for, are employed by, cash your checks from, they are the people who review said subdivisions. So what this smells like to me is a conflict of interest. But let's check out our answer choices, and let's see what the answer choices tell us about this scenario. Answer choice 1. Disclose your participation in the project to your boss and get written permission from city planning. B, disclose your current role as a city planner and tell your uncle, what you do for a living. Third, disclose your participation in the project to your boss, i.e. the city. Or 4, disclose your current role as city planner to your uncle and get your uncle's written permission to continue the job. So somebody is going to have to be told something. But I wonder, who is this meant to protect? Your day job or your night job?
Why waste valuable time memorizing equations and working out all of those long mathematical questions? Purchase a pre-programmed HP35 from NLC that works the problems for you in seconds and frees up more time to work on the rest of your exam. Programs include COGO, triangles, horizontal and vertical curves, and many more.
If you've got a question like this, conflict of interest, then you need to go to the California statutes. Which statute will be your problem? Because you have to have a very, very good understanding of all of the different surveying-related laws in California, and you have to know where to look to find some answers. Well, I'm lazy, so I pulled out my own California statutes binder, which we sell at NLC Test Prep, and I looked up acts and rules, and I just started paging through them. And I found this. There is a 4-pronged conflict of interest section. We're not going to go through all of them because this would take all day, but if you have related jobs, you have to disclose it. If you have a financial interest in the work you are paid to do, you have to disclose it. You may not take kickbacks from clients, contractors, or employers. And finally, let's read number 4, because number 4 is going to be our hot ticket to solve this situation. Number 4 says, a licensee, while engaged by a government agency as an officer, employee, appointee, agent, or consultant, shall not engage in the professional engineering business or activity that may be subject to a licensee's direct or indirect control, inspection, review, audit, or enforcement, unless the circumstances have been disclosed, here it is, in writing. Quick tip, if something smells funny with a conflict of interest, you need to get it in writing that it is okay to proceed. So in this situation, you cannot build a plat, review your own plat, and then approve it as a city employee. That would be not good. So what you should do is, you should go to your boss at the city planning department. You should tell him the situation. You should get his written permission to build this subdivision. And then someone else, not you, should review it for the county. So which of these best fits that conflict of interest rule? Personally, I think it's A. You should disclose your participation to your boss, and you should also get his written permission as agent of the city planning department. If it smells funny, don't do it. If it smells funny, get written permission from your boss. This is not to protect your uncle. This is to protect the citizens of the city or county in which you're practicing.
Want even more content for the California PLS exam? Join us for a complete online prep course that includes videos, handouts, workbooks, practice questions, and a full-length practice exam. This course has everything you need to pass the California PLS on your first try. Join me at nlcprep.com/CA for more information.